regreso aquí en Auto 060 y rápidamente vamos a pasar al test ride del nuevo Toyota Highlander 2014 que probamos aquí en Miami, en Coral Gables, con Brian Formenta. Esto fue durante el almuerzo mensual de la Southern Automotive Media Association.
How are you, Brian?
How are you doing? I'm Brian. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. So we're now in the 2014 new Highlander, right?
Yes, sir. That's correct.
So made in USA?
100%.
Indiana. And actually, a lot of people don't know, but a lot of Toyotas are made in the States, right?
That's correct.
Yeah. So let's go and drive a little bit, and you can tell me what's new in this car, which I think pretty much everything is
everything,
new, right?
From the design to the interior. It's been 100% renewed. When you look at the interior of the vehicle, you actually have a in-dash shelving.
Yeah, I like this a lot. I don't think I've seen that in any modern car, actually.
No, I haven't either. Some competitors have somewhat of a shelving, but this actually goes throughout here before it hits the driver. And it's very, very convenient. You can put your cell phone on there.
Oh, that's what this little slot is for. Yeah. I was wondering before I saw it.
Yeah, you can run your cord through there. And that way the cords are not hanging out everywhere.
And where does the USB port is?
You have a USB port down here and an auxiliary.
Oh, okay.
And you have a 12 volt point here, and you also have one here in the roll top center console.
Yeah, you always need more than one in these cars nowadays.
Yeah, with all the kids and with all the phones we have. So you have one right there. Well, that leads me to talk about the roll top center console. You have over 5 gallons of storage capacity in here. So it's enough to fit one of a big purse, you name it, large articles, a cat, if you travel with your cat or a dog.
Or dog, I think a chihuahua can fit there pretty easily. Maybe a little padding and then he'll be comfortable.
Yeah. In this particular model, they have heated and cooled seats, which you'll find standard on the Limited. Right now we're in the Limited with the tech package, which the tech package includes a few things. You have the dynamic radar cruise control, a pre-collision system, automatic high beams with the lane departure alert warning as well, and also a safety warning, which we call Safety Connect. So in event you're ever in an accident, it actually will call emergency vehicles to you.
Yeah, absolutely. And this is the thing, I mean, this is not officially a luxury vehicle, but it's a lot of things that it used to be only in luxury vehicles, right?
That's 100% correct. So it's very close, not luxury line, but very, you're 100% correct. It is very close. You can compare it to our sister company, the Lexus. You see a lot of things that you'll see normal in luxury vehicles, like the ambient lighting, which is the soft blue touch lighting that you'll see in these shelving and around the doors in the front and the back, which you'll find in standard on the Limited trim level.
So how many trims are in this the new Highlander?
You get a total. You have the LE, LE Plus, XLE, and the Limited. So it's 4 trim levels, and you also have a hybrid available.
So 5 different models?
5 different.
And what's the price range?
You have the LE, which can start anywhere from the low 30s. And when you look at the Limited with the Platinum package, you're looking at about 44, 45. The hybrid is always a little more.
Yeah.
You're looking at a difference of about $4,000 in the hybrid.
So again, like a ton of technology, like very cool design. And that's something that I've been very critical of Toyota in the past, and the design wasn't very good. But now the new ones, every single model, the Corolla, the Avalon. I think it started with the Avalon, actually, like the first model that was completely redesigned with the new face of Toyota, as they called it, right?
The new face did start with the Avalon, but you saw with the new Camry in 2012, you saw some small things coming. But yeah, you're right, the Avalon was the first one to have that new face.
Yeah. And another thing about the Highlander is in a very competitive segment, but you still have some key advantages.
Correct, yes. Key advantages is obviously the roll top center console. In any market, we usually typically dominate. We're in the top 3. Along up there, it would be with Ford and Jeep. So we definitely always one of the top selling in the midsize SUV segment. And it's a growing segment. We projected a grow over 10%. And we want to definitely get a piece of that, right?
Absolutely, And there's a lot of competition. I mean, everybody, pretty much every manufacturer has a... this is a mid-size SUV, it's
mid-size
called,
SUV, yes.
Even though it fits 8 people.
You're right. That's the key thing, it fits 8 passengers up to 8. When you go into the Limited trim levels, it fits 7 because you get the captain's chairs.
Yeah.
But now the third row is very, very functional. So you can easily fit 3 passengers in the third row.
And one more thing, safety, very important for every manufacturer, especially with Toyota. And one thing that I think you're doing, at least with this model first, is like you're including the rear view camera standard in every model.
100%. All trim levels will have a standard backup camera, which is an added value in a core, and also an addition with safety, absolutely. And also you get 8 airbags in this vehicle. Right, so you get a driver knee, a passenger seat cushion, the dual stage airbags, the side bolster airbags for the seats for the front passengers, and you get rear curtain airbags, side curtain airbags that go all the way back to the third row.
Yeah, and yeah, because of that, you got the top safety pick for the IHS immediately after the car came out, right?
Correct, yeah. We're the first car in this segment to do the test and get that top safety pick plus rating.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you very much for your time, and we're going to keep enjoying the drive here and the new Highlander so around beautiful Coral Gables here in Miami.
Yes, I love Miami.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.